Hello everyone, hope you all are doing good. Today, I'm going to explain about performance analytics indicators. Okay, let's see. Our agenda is, what is indicators and indicator sources? What are the indicator types? And how to create indicators and indicator source and how to collect the data. Okay, it's some lab practical. Okay, let's see a demo. Okay, now what is indicators and indicator sources? You know, an indicator is a process metric defined to continuously measure some specific process characteristics or behavior. Okay, it's nothing but, for example, a number of incidents. Number of open incident is a business process table. Okay, so to calculate some metrics, okay, so we will build some indicators on that incident management incident table. Okay, so that's what an indicator. Okay, so indicator source defines the subset of data you want to see from business tables. Okay, for example, number of open incidents. Okay, is an indicator. So this indicator is depend on indicator source. Indicator source is getting like what data you want from the business tables. So we will configure in indicator source. Using this indicator source, we will configure indicators. Okay, so we will see. So you will understand when we go to demo. Okay, and indicator types. We have three types of indicators. One, it is automated indicators. What it means? It means is nothing but the data populated, okay, by scheduled data collection. Okay. Once configured, indicator data trends are built automatically over time. Example is number of open incidents, number of average incidents, count of average incidents, all these things. Okay, all called automated indicators. Okay, we will see automated indicators, how to create automated indicators in this section. Second one is formula indicators. Formula indicator is nothing but is constructed by combining one or more existing indicators in a mathematical statement. Okay, if you take two automated indicators, okay, so you build formula indicators, okay, using two automated indicators or more automated indicators. Okay, for example, you can see the percentile of the new critical incident indicator is calculated by dividing the total of new critical incidents by the total of all new incidents and multiplying the result by 100. Okay, here we have new critical incident. Total of new critical incident is an automated indicator, and total of all new incident is an other automated indicator. Okay, so building some formula here to create a new formula indicator. Okay, and third one is manual indicator. Manual indicator are based on manually imported external data. For example, if you have Excel data, okay, you want to create some indicators using that Excel. Okay, so the data does not exist in your service now, and you have an Excel, and you need to create some indicators using that Excel data. Okay, that is called manual indicators. Okay, so today in our demo lab, we are creating a new indicator. Okay, using guided indicator workflow and also manually. Okay, and how we are going to collect and view indicator data in dashboard. Okay, creating a new indicator source or something like that. Okay, so let's see our lab. Okay, let's do it.
Please do subscribe to get alerts for upcoming videos. Hope you will enjoy and learn ServiceNow. Thank you very much for your time.